Hey there, geeks and geekettes. We're going to unbox the Punisher.
Oh, yeah.
Now, I have done a lot of videos on Marvel stuff and superheroes and rankings and all the rest of it, and I've said on a number of occasions that the Punisher is my favourite non-powered superhero from the Marvel universe. In the DC universe, it's obviously Batman. Overall, non-powered, it's Batman, but I do love me some Punisher. So this is the Marvel Legends series, and it is the Punisher. So we've got the standard black box, we've got the Punisher logo on the top. Some nice Punisher comic book art there. Same on this side. Hasbro 4 Plus, choking hazard, small parts, not for children under 3. And then we get a product shot, giant product shot there, smaller ones there which show off the bike. The number plate which says PNSH, which is Punish, and 616. 616, if you don't know, is the universe in the multiverse in which the real or the proper original Marvel universe takes place. Handlebars, speedometer, war helmet, yeah. But we'll look at all that bit in a little while. Frank Castle rides through the night dispensing brutal vigilante justice. And then we've got all this boring shit, followed by more boring shit. I'm not going into all that. Now, the only reason I haven't bought any Marvel Legends for so long, and it's been months and months, is because I can't afford them. After getting furloughed, changing jobs, and then other stuff happening, I just couldn't afford it. So, let's get him out. Ooh. In the back of the box, we have this awesome looking Punisher skull. Smoky effect. Oh, I want to keep that. All of my legends are out of box, but one over there and my Toy Vizira because they're rare. So, without as much glare, let's take a look. We've got Punisher with his beat up face, his regular face. We've got a sawn off shotgun. We've got a Mac 10, I believe, and an M5, I think. I play Call of Duty a lot. We've got a war helmet, which I'm not going to put on the character because I don't like the look of it. We got a big ass machete, a baseball bat, handlebars, and the all important motorcycle. Now, if this is anything like the Captain America one, this is going to be a ball ache to get out. Very nice. Why did I just turn into Borat? So, for obvious reasons and packaging, they've separated. I need more room. They package this separate and flat to stop obviously any damage. So, there is a clip with two little prongs there. So, that'll obviously secure in there. Thankfully, there is no saddlebags in this one because the saddlebags on the Captain America bike. Oh, ouch. So, there's different handlebars on this. Captain America bike has the wider handlebars associated with the Harleys used in World War II, whereas this has got the hangers, which is more sort of modern. It is all blacked out. It is a matte black, which I like. Wheels move. He's got the Punisher number plate on the back there. He's actually got the peg for the saddlebags that's on the other bike, but I'm not doing that. The single seat, number plate, brake light because it's a side mounted plate, which I like. Obviously there's the Harley V-twin engine. I wonder if they've had a paid license for this, because that's definitely a Harley. Headlights, and on the dial there is a Punisher skull on the speedometer. This bike feels more sturdy than the last one, with less bits. because I don't have to clip bits on. So it's also got a kickstand, which will double for this bike to stand either on 2 feet or one and lean it. Ooh, that's a good looking bike. I just dropped a machine gun. I've got a black carpet. That was really hard to find. Frank Castle is out of the box. He comes with two heads and a war helmet. So we've got the beaten up head on there, which I'm keeping on the figure. And we've got the regular head there. It's got his widow peak, his blue eyes. That's very well painted. There's no immediate flaws on this. Very tidy in the back. It's good health to head sculpt, which I may try out on an older Punisher figure I've got there, but I don't like the head sculpt. Now, this war helmet is really cool. I'm just not going to put it on the figure because I don't think he needs it. And this is from a comic. I'm just not fussed on the image of it. So this is the head sculpt I'll be keeping, with obviously the split over his eyebrow and down his cheek, his forehead there. Still got the widow's peak, the slick back hair. Obviously his Punisher vest there. This isn't a tactical vest. This, unlike one of the figures I've got there, this is just a t-shirt. He's got the holster, shoulder holsters, but I don't think that's going to hold anything. None of the weapons have pegs to sit on there, so I'm guessing that's been reused from another figure. He's got his fingerless gloves, trigger fingers on both hands, as he should have. Magazine clips there. No gun holsters, which is odd. And obviously his boots. So articulation looks all the way up and all the way down. Ooh, his head actually shifts. You shift the head back and forth. Not much in the way of side pivot on the head. There's a little bit. And of course it will spin 360. Shoulders are... ooh. There's a bit of shifting in the shoulder there. There is a bit of paint bleed. They've missed the vest and gone onto his arm. But that far away, you can't tell. This close, you can. Rotates the shoulder 360. There's your lift up. Lifts out on a ratchet joint to there. Bicep swivel. Double hinged elbows. Give himself a nice hug. The ratchet joints on this are really stiff, which is a good thing because the figure won't go loose over time. His wrists are on a hinge and swivel. Ball, that's a ratchet as well. Oh. He has a torso crunch, goes this much forward, this much back. Ooh, that's quite fat. He does not have a waist swivel. And he doesn't really have much in the way of a swivel on the upper body at all. His legs kick out almost 90 degrees. Double hinged knee. Unfortunately, because of his big ass calves, he cannot kick his own ass. Seems like ages since I've said that. His feet are on rockers and a swivel ball joint. There's a nice lot of articulation in there. And kick forward and back just a little bit. Now the big one is going to be, will he sit on the bike? Because my Captain America, he sits on the bike, but it's very hard to do and very awkward. On to Frank's accessories. That could have done with a bit of blood on it, but otherwise it's decent enough. Not a great deal of detail. There is a plastic baseball bat, which could have done with some wood grain, I suppose, but when you've got a motorcycle with that much detail and a figure that well detailed, I can forgive that. And it's a baseball bat. How much detail do you want something that small? But this sawn off double barrel shotgun, I really like that. There's a lot of detail in it. I'm definitely posing the character with that. And he's obviously got his two weapons. This, I assume, is an MP5 style weapon. Or an Uzi. That's too big for an Uzi. There's a stock there which would pull out, but obviously on this it's just one piece. Just matte black. And then we've got, I think that might actually be a KG9. And I only know that because in Sons of Anarchy, this gun is used. But very good looking guns. So I'm going to pause the video there. I'm going to try and get Frank posed up on the motorcycle. So there is Frank on his motorcycle. Alongside Captain America on his. There's enough variations in the bikes to make them worth having both in the collection. As you can see, this Captain America won't hold the handlebars and put his feet on the pegs, whereas Frank Castle does. This Captain America, I've really struggled getting on the motorcycle and bits kept falling off. They still do, hence the gun sat there instead of on the front wheel. This Frank Castle, it went on quite easy. There was no forcing of the hands, etc. Even the shotgun went into his hand quite easily, and I'm quite impressed. And there's the other two Punishers up there. So, I'm really, really happy with this figure. Badass. Yeah, that's my new favourite Marvel, I think. Marvel Legends, I think. That was my unboxing of the Marvel Legends Punisher with motorcycle. In the comment section down below, let me know what you think of this figure. It will be the last Marvel Legends I buy with a motorcycle. They just take up too much room. And I'm borderline out of room in my new, bigger room. Please like, comment, share, subscribe, all that YouTube stuff to help the channel to grow, etc. I've been the Bearded Geek, and I will catch you soon for another review or an unboxing. Goodbye.